Welcome back. This is The Circle Live. Our next guest is a savvy businesswoman, philanthropist, multimedia entrepreneur, and super funny comedian.
Of course, she never shies away from sharing her opinions daily on CBS's The Talk. Please welcome Emmy Award winner, Sheryl Underwood.
Yes. I'm glad to be in the sister circle.
Yes. Glad to have you.
Okay, where are we starting, ladies?
We're going to start with something very nice and cute and quaint. Toys for Tots with the Marine Corps.
Yes.
What are you doing for the holidays?
Well, that was part of a rap battle episode. You know, rap battle is a game show. It's a gift wrapping game show on Freeform. And the Marines were part of that episode. But what I love about the Marines, we just came out of the Bayou Classic. And the Marines sponsor the Battle of the Band. They came out and they played Beyonce's song. So could you picture the Marine Corps playing Beyonce in New Orleans? It was amazing.
That's good.
So you are multifaceted. You don't just do The Talk. You have a radio show that has 45 outlets.
Yes.
And what made you? I'm not going to limit you. 451.
That's right.
Outlets.
Yes.
Correction. Get it right. What made you do a radio show?
Well, I started in radio consistently with Tom Joyner, and I saw what Tom Joyner was doing, and all the women that were in radio before me, and I said, well, I want to do something too. And so then, you know, in working with him, I learned about radio. Then I moved on to Steve Harvey, which I'm a contributor on the Steve Harvey Morning Show right now. But, you know, sometimes we do things, but then we want to do our own thing. So I said, I want to do my own thing. So I put my little money together. We got one station. Then we lost that one station. But I always put God first. And I said, Lord, obviously, this is something I can do. Now let me lead you. Let me let you lead me. And then we figure out how we gonna do this. And now we have 451 stations. We have 49 out of 500 affiliates. We are on all over the globe. We just got on in Pakistan. We're on in Beijing. We're on all over the globe. But we're on 22 HBCU stations. And we're doing low power. You know, we got and we have different formats. So we have 5 day a week radio. Then we have The House Party, which is our hip hop show, Late Night Cupcaking, which is our Quiet Storm show, and Spiritual Nourishment, which is our gospel show.
That's fantastic.
So we do all that, and then we're gonna do a network. So when you ladies get ready to do some radio.
Well, you know, that is my foundation, radio.
That's right.
12 years here.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so talk about the Black Radio Solidarity movement, and what is the goal of
Black Radio Solidarity, it started as Black Radio Solidarity Day in 2016. And it's where Steve and I and Tom Joyner, matter of fact, Tom Joyner gave us our 5 goals that we needed, and we all worked together. Sway, everybody was working together on it. So we decided to do it as a year to drive souls to the polls from 2019 all the way to 2020. The largest voting block is the non-voter. We can sway all elections if we just go out and vote. So we want you to not just register man polling place, but we want you to take people to vote. Get your church van. Don't tell them how to vote, but take them to vote. Then the next thing we want you to do under Black Radio Solidarity is to fill out your census form. Black and brown people are afraid of the census. Don't be afraid of the census. So I'm going to Houston in 2 weeks to sit in the census 2020 meeting so that we can get everything about the census. And here's the catch of this. If you fill it out online, they're not coming to your house. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. You don't want to knock on the door? Fill it out online. That's what I'm telling you. Then the last thing is we're coming together. It's a coalition of organizations coming together where we're going to have the March for Jobs and Freedom 2020, a historical recreation of the 1963 March on Washington.
Well,
so we'll tell you a little bit about that after the break, because I see that young lady right there, that young sister, got the card up a minute.
We got time for one more question.
One more question. What's one more question?
It's coming from Tanya.
Listen.
I mean, you do everything. You're taking people to the polls, you're building radio stations. How do you find the balance between, you know, being a host in your everyday life and things you're doing? Like, tell us how you do it.
My day starts about 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning. We do the radio. We make sure that we're ready. And that helps me with The Talk. Yeah. So you know the good topics. You know what I'm talking about. Doing all that show prep with The Talk. But the other thing that I love, first I put God first. Yes. Then I know I got to get some sleep. Then I got to drink some water. Then I got to exercise. You know, then I got to get my fiber. Shout out Metamucil. I know I wasn't supposed to say that. Hey, Metamucil.
All the way through.
Listen to me. You got to stop playing the orange. And then they got cookies. Y'all need to come on with me. But this is the other thing that happens, too. As a woman, you've got to have your sister.
Yes.
You've got to have somebody you go to, and then, you know, what you get with the fellas if it happens. It don't have to happen, but I'll be here at the Uptown weekend, so it could happen.
You gotta plug yourself, but of course, it's always a pleasure having you down to the circle to follow Sheryl on Instagram. It's simply at Sheryl Underwood.
All right, if you're sticking around for the full hour, we're gonna talk a little bit more, and of course, the conversation always continues at Sister Circle TV on all social media platforms.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. We are at the table with the amazing Sheryl Underwood, and now the president and CEO of the NAACP, Derrick Johnson, joins us. We're happy to have you here.
Good to be here.
This is absolutely fantastic. It's a joy to share space with you. And Sheryl, let's talk a little bit about the Continue the Legacy initiative.
So it is an opportunity for civil rights groups like SCLC, under the celebrityship of Sheryl Underwood, to really focus on the 2020 civic engagement reality. We have the census coming up, we have elections across the country, and we have to remove racism from the White House. And that's the focus right now.
Right. And what would you say to that as well?
Well, what we really wanted to do was go back, because the blueprint has already been laid for us. 1941, Mighty Man of Phi Beta Sigma, A. Philip Randolph, had a vision, and it came to fruition in 1963 with Bayard Rustin. But he came together with organizations, Dr. Steele, SCLC, and Reverend Johnson with NAACP, and we're talking to Urban League, we're talking to everybody. Jan Temple's here, we're gonna have a meeting, and she's with A. Philip Randolph Institute. Cleola Brown is their president and CEO, and what we're doing is bringing those organizations together.
That's great.
So we can tell people, you study history, now come on out to Washington, D.C., let's make some history.
Yes.
Once we wake you up to vote and fill out that census form, then we're gonna wake you up to coalesce together to save our democracy one vote at a time.
Love it.
I love it, Sheryl.
Yes. Well, go ahead, Ty.
I know y'all excited.
No,
this is really important. So we're just excited to talk about this. And you're so vocal in the political world. How do you like work to get this messaging out there? Like, what are the points that we can take home and everyone at home understands?
So I think most importantly is understanding our power. Our vote is our currency. Yeah. And in this democracy, it will be subverted if we don't step up. It is the power of black women. Mm-hmm. It is the power of our community as a whole. And history has taught us when we fight, we win.
Yes.
The problem for black folks, we're not fighting the right fights enough.
Yes.
So as your listeners think about it, what can we do? You can make sure you register to vote. You can make sure your neighbor registered to vote. Okay. You can fill out the census, and you can heed the call of programs like this.
Right. So to clarify, why is it so important for us, for black and brown people, to fill out the census? You keep saying it, but what is the reason behind it?
It's so people money is apportion money, appropriation money, and it's representation.
Okay.
When you're talking about your representation in the House and the Senate, see, when you're talking about what the Senate is blocking right now, you can change all of that. And see, the biggest thing about this is also funding. You know, people come to us for entertainment. They come to us for fashion. Mm-hmm. Now they need to come to us for intellectual capacity and political strength. Mm-hmm. So now we got people that are coming. Like right now, there's an organization called Debt Stoppers. Mm-hmm. They're a law firm out of Chicago. They have brought a check for $25,000 to help us fund the historical recreation of the 1963 March on Washington. And they're also funding two town hall meetings in Atlanta and Chicago. And we're going to Jackson, Mississippi. We got to go to
your town. Home.
That's right. So it's everybody coalescing together.
That's good.
But most important with the census, anytime you ride down the highway and you see construction, that's because of the census data say that's a high traffic area.
Right.
Anytime you see a new building going up for children, the census data drive the funding from that.
Right.
And for black folks, we got to make sure we're accounted so the money comes to where it needs to go.
And I think that's been a huge misunderstanding in terms of the African American community. We were not sure in terms of why are we being counted, and honestly, we kind of strayed away from that. Like, you know, I don't trust the government.
That's right.
Right.
We
fear.
What are you going to do with that information?
What are you going to do with that information?
And how is it going to be used against me? And I think it's incumbent upon all of us who hold a microphone and lead organizations to get clarity about this issue.
Yeah.
But I think the biggest thing, too, is to see people working together.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And when we were disenfranchised, we were closer together. Mm-hmm. But people want to separate us. Mm-hmm. Well, today on Sister Circle, right here, this is the first time you you will ever see the organizations coming together.
Yes.
So I'm really proud of Sister Circle and that you're allowing us.
I about to say, first time we come together, you was our ambassador one
year.
Yes,
sir was. Sure was. Is there anything I'm missing? Is something I'm missing?
Another question.
Oh, okay.
But I have a question for you. You know, in giving this clarity, do you ever feel censored in your political views and how you have to display what you feel when it comes to television and radio?
Never. Never. I've never been censored. You've seen me on CBS The Talk. Mm-hmm. You know, we're not a political show, but we do talk about the issues of the day. Mm-hmm. CBS has never censored me. They, matter of fact, they've never said anything about my hair.
Yeah.
And each time it changed, they'd be like, bravo! But even on radio. But I am respectful. We're on, Sheryl Underwood Radio is on in Beijing, China. We were respectful of the protests in Hong Kong, mm-hmm. but also the government of China. Mm-hmm. So we have to do that to bring people together. First, you have to respect them. And can I do this real fast, too? I got to shout out Warren Ballantyne, who's our truth fighter. He has his own radio show.
Fantastic.
And Harry Sutherland, who's on my radio show, who's an elected county commissioner, is here. And Erna Fouché, she's the executive director of PACRAT Foundation for Education. And our focus is HBCUs. We want money to get HBCU buses to come to Washington, D.C. Okay. Because some of us were kids in 1963 when that march happened. But we want these street soldiers to bring your child. And we want college students to understand you have power too.
Yes.
So meet us in Washington, D.C., where we historically recreate the 1963 March on Washington.
Where can people find more information?
At blackradiosolidarity.com.
That's real easy.
That's right.
Sheryl, what's next for you as we are on the way out? What's next for you outside of what's going on here?
Well, I'm missing my sorrow, Selena Johnson. I'm missing the Zeta Becca because it is centennial year.
It
100
is.
Years of scholarship service, sisterhood, and founder womanhood. Z Fighter, my sorrow is a beta. I know you got other organizations. And I'm at Uptown Comedy Club this weekend. I need to sell this out because I love eBay. eBay been very good to me, and I love to shop. Late at night, I love to shop.
Thank you so much for Derrick Johnson.
Oh, and Nisa Green did my face.
Yes. Emmy Award winner,
Nisa Green.
Well, to the president and CEO of the NAACP, Derrick Johnson, to our good friend, our sister, Sheryl Underwood, we love you so much. Continued success on everything. Please make sure you follow Sheryl Underwood on Instagram to keep up with everything she has going on.